Hi and welcome to a new Bitwig Studio tutorial. Today we're going to take a look at the new Bitwig Studio 2.3 beta. And in the new beta version they've added a new synthesizer called Phase 4. It contains four oscillators, red, blue, yellow and purple. So let's create the bell sound. They've added a new button here which will expand the view of the synthesizer. And we can see exactly how each waveform behaves. The red one looks like a sine wave something. The second one is also a sine wave. And it says saw here, but since the shape button here is set to 0%, it will be a sine wave. But if we increase it to 100% of the sawtooth shape, it will be a sawtooth. So if we begin setting it to a sine wave and drag the modulation to the bottom, if we want to modulate the red oscillator with the blue one, we need to increase the modulation button here to maybe 400%, 300 something. And then if we increase this blue button here, we can see that it starts to modulate the red oscillator more and more. So if we set it to in the middle here somewhere and increase the pitch of the blue oscillator, maybe set it to 24 or something, a very high pitch, so we get the bellish kind of sound. And we also increase the release time to the bell. There we have something more similar to a bell. We can make this more bellish sounding if we add an attack to the sound. And we can do that by adding a modulator, by pressing this little button down to the left. And if we press one of the plus signs, we can add a modulator, and let's add an ADSR. And in order to make this modulate something, we need to press this dot, the green dot and arrow button, and we can see that all the green buttons can be modulated. And maybe we can make it modulate, increase the modulation of the blue oscillator. And we drag this attack all the way to the left to get a sharp attack. Maybe have it modulate more. And make the second oscillator, the blue oscillator, get some modulation from the yellow and purple one too. And if we increase this, it will be a more sharp tone. And we can also utilize the new voice stacking mode. It's only available, I think, if you press the expand view. We can see that it's currently the stacking is only one voice, and we can increase it if we drag it upwards to two, so we get two voices. And we can tell the first voice, if we press the first voice, we can adjust so that it's modulated to the left of the panning and the second to the right in the panning. And if we listen now, we don't hear much because we need to make the second voice a little bit different. We do that by pressing the second voice and adjusting the pitch a little. And maybe so that it has more modulation from the yellow oscillator. And you have to be careful when you're using the voice stacking because you have a limit here and it will start to cut off tone notes if you're pressing a lot of notes. So just increase this to maybe 16 if you're using the stacking. Now it works a lot better. We can add a reverb to the effect section here. Let's add some Valhalla room. And maybe some delay. The Replica XT, an excellent delay from Native Instruments. Let's make it ping pong some. And cut some of the highs. So, that's about it for now. It's a simple bell sound. And thanks for watching.